Welcome to the Tickmill Update. I'm Kiana Danielle, the founder of the Invest Diva movement. On Wednesday, we found out that the door is open for Bank of Canada to cut interest rates if the current economic slowdown persists. The central bank left the key interest rate unchanged at 1.75%. We also found out that the U.S. home sales jumped to their highest level in nearly 2 years in December, the latest indication that lower mortgage rates are helping the housing market to regain its footing after hitting a soft patch in 2018. Meanwhile, Trump said U.S. economic growth would be closer to 4% if it weren't for the lingering effect of Federal Reserve rate hikes. And he also threatened to impose high tariffs on imports of cars from the European Union if the bloc doesn't agree to a trade deal. On the other side of the pond, the UK manufacturing business optimism improved at the strongest pace since 2014. On Thursday, we have the ECB rate decision and consumer price index numbers out of New Zealand and Japan. Today, I'm looking at the Kiwi yen pair, which could be in the process of forming a double top bearish reversal chart pattern. The pair recently dove inside the 4-hour Ichimoku cloud, with a future cloud bearish. Our bearish signal could get stronger if the pair actually breaks below the Ichimoku cloud in the coming days, but this could also turn out to be a temporary pullback in the longer-term uptrend. So with that, I would cap any short positions at the 78% Fibonacci retracement level of 72.10 and then look for new signals. Now, I'd like to hear from you. Do you think the recent bearish movement for Kiwi yen is here to stay, or is it temporary? Let me know down in the comments. Of course, trading the financial markets involves a risk of loss, and you should only trade the money that you can afford to lose. If you like this video, give it a thumbs up and subscribe to the Tickmill YouTube channel. I'll get back to you with more updates tomorrow.